In this video, we're going to take a look at Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor, which is an add-on pack for Elementor that was just released. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell, and YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. I'll have a link to this product down in the video description box, or you can go to WPCrafter.com/UAE, Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor. Let's just go ahead and take a look at what this add-on adds to Elementor and see if it's even worth considering. So here we are on their website. You could just head on over there. I just said the link, the link's down below, all that kind of good stuff. There is a little bit of a time-sensitive matter with it. Since they just launched this, having a little launch promotion, so you might want to consider that. All right, what this is going to do is add some really neat things that we're going to take a look at to your Elementor-based website. Now, right now, it has a total of 8 additional modules, features, and they're really cool that they're going to add, that it will add to Elementor for you. I want to talk about these for a moment. You know, one of the things that I've been a little vocal about it with these Elementor add-on packs is having an add-on pack that doesn't just do what Elementor Pro does, but actually brings something new to the table. There's another add-on pack that nails this, and I'm happy to say that I think Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor as well nails this point. They're not trying to compete with Elementor Pro. They're trying to expand and extend what you can do with Elementor and Elementor Pro. I just wanted to bring that up real quick. Okay, so here are the 8 modules that it adds. Now, they have a public roadmap available of what they're working on. Some of the things that they're, I know they're working on based upon that public roadmap is stylers for other contact form plugins like Gravity Forms, Caldera Forms, WP Forms, stuff like that. And there's a bunch of other stuff they're adding, a table module, a whole bunch of things like that. Things that Elementor Pro doesn't have, but I want to just talk about the 8 things that it does have right now, because these are things that aren't available for Elementor users right now. So let's just list them out and then take a look at them real quick. The first one is the info box. I love the info box. I use this on some of their other add-on products for other page builders. Here's one of the ones that's not out there yet. It's a pop-up, the most flexible, powerful pop-up builder for Elementor. It's right here now available to you. Dual color heading, that is actually really neat. I'm gonna look at the demo here on the website and show you, because I want you to see what it can do. I'm not gonna show you myself with it. Before and after slider, that's pretty neat. Advanced heading, there's multi buttons, fancy heading, and content toggle. Now, when you come to their website, you can click on any of these and see demos of them to see everything that they can do. Let's go ahead and take a look at these that I'm not gonna actually show you, but we'll just take a quick look together. So first of all, let's take a look at this dual color heading. I think this is very unique and is gonna allow you to add a lot of style to your Elementor-based website. So here's an example. You see where it says border and background? That's an example of this fancy heading where you can take a bit of text and do different things, like with backgrounds, borders, fonts. You can have them be different. So here's an example. I could think of a lot of great uses for this. Right here is an example of using different fonts. Right here's an example of using a background image actually on some of the text. I hope you're seeing these are features that don't currently exist for Elementor users. The different weight for the font right here, and then here you can create your own unique style. I think this is really neat. I'm glad they made this and added that. So that was going to be the dual color heading. Let's go ahead and now take a look at the, I'm gonna actually show you the fancy heading, the content toggle. Actually, you know what? Let's just go ahead and jump on into what I'm doing with this. First, let's take a quick look at the price. It's discounted for a short period of time. I know it's normally $69. They've discounted it to $49. And if you wanted to get a lifetime license, it's normally $249. They lowered that down to $199. That's a very good deal. If you are an Astra agency license holder, the good news for you is that you already have access to this. It's included in the Astra agency bundle package. Here's how the Astra agency works. It comes with the Astra theme and a bunch of other goodies, including this. It comes with so much, actually. $250 per year. It's a fabulous deal. Okay, so I have it opened up right here, right now in Elementor. And I just want to show you just those three things, this animated text, this modal pop-up, and the content toggle, which I think is the coolest feature that they have added. Okay, so first of all, we have this animated text right here. Now, I'll tell you, Elementor Pro already has an animated text module. In fact, I use it on the homepage of my website. Now, the problem that I've experienced with the one that comes with Elementor, I'm not going to be harsh on Elementor and say it's half-baked. It's not half-baked. It's a very powerful add-on that comes with Elementor Pro. The thing is it doesn't give you a lot of the control that I would want to have. Have you noticed that it's scrolling extremely, extremely slow? Yes, it's because you have the option to set the pace and the speed. So when I click on this, right here, you say your first part of the text, your second part of the text, and if you wanted something at the end, you could do that as well. Now, when you click on effect, right now it's a little limited in effects options. I'm sure more are gonna come. Right now you have the slide or you can do the type, but here is where the power comes in. Let me click on slide. I've got the animation speed setting, so that's gonna be how long it takes to actually do its slide. And then you have a option of how long it will stay on that slide. These are just options that aren't with the animated text module in Elementor Pro. I wish it was, but it's not. So that's one thing that I really like. I'm actually going to switch mine out to this because I want a little bit more control over how it actually displays on my website. The next is right here, and this is the modal pop-up. And this is powerful stuff. You can do every type of pop-up, put any type of content in the pop-up. There's different effects. You can even do that exit intent. So the pop-up will only trigger when someone's leaving your website. It's just filled with features. I suggest actually we should just do this real quick. We should jump on here and make sure I cover them all right now. Here's all the possibilities, the different types of content, photo, video, saved page template, saved section, saved widget. You could do so many different things. You could put whatever content you want in there and make it look beautiful. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on it. So the first thing here is your content. So right now it is set to content, photo, video embed. You can have where the power is the save section, saved page, and you can put in your video embed links. This is what would pop up, okay? That could be used a full page if you wanna show off some full page designs. You could do that now in a pop-up. I really like that. And then you put the content here. So since it says photo, if I was to change this to a saved page like this, then I can choose the page. I don't have any saved pages. That's why I don't get an option there. If I wanted a YouTube video, just choose YouTube, and then I can pop in my URL, and then I have some additional control options for that video. Next, we have the modal pop-up right here, so you could choose the width of the actual pop-up in the effect, and there's a variety of effects here on how that pop-up will enter the viewport, and then you can choose an overlay color as well. Next is the close button right here. So you can have it be an icon or an image. You can change the size of it. You have full control over how the pop-up can actually go away. And one of the ones I like is close on overlay click. That is the one setting I would have. Nothing is more annoying than when there's a pop-up and you have to move your mouse all the way over to the X, wherever it is on the screen, and click in that specific location. You have those options to have it work in a different way. Now here is the interesting part. We have display settings, and this is what is going to show on the front end to trigger the pop-up. Remember, it could also be exit intent or someone's moving off of the page. So let's go ahead and take a look at those options right now. So here you can choose an icon, an image, text, or a button. That would be what is clicked on to trigger the pop-up, or you can have some kind of custom class ID for some of you guys that are a little bit more advanced with the coding. You can go ahead and do that. It's actually, you don't even have to be advanced. It's so easy with Elementor to begin with. Now, when you choose automatic, so right now it's on button, obviously, but when I click on automatic, the options beneath it go away and I can enable exit intent after a few seconds or enable cookies. Actually, I don't even know. Oh, here's the cookies. Obviously you can have control based upon cookies. So this would be, if someone sees it, you can say, don't show to that person for another 7 days. That's what enable cookies is going to do. So exit intent is when the mouse moves off the viewport after a few seconds is actually pretty obvious. You can choose how many seconds it will trigger. And then you have your typical options here of not triggering every time that same person is on your website. If you went with a button, you have, so each one of these different options here, they will have these dynamic settings for it. It all makes sense if you're comfortable and used to Elementor. Next, I want to talk about what I think is the coolest feature. I've never seen this anywhere. I've never seen it for any other page builder. I've never seen it in any other add-on package. I could be wrong, but I think I'm right this time because I would have seen it. And this is something that I think is brilliant for them to add to their add-on package. And I guarantee this, mark my words, today when you watch this video, this is going to be the one feature that everybody probably copycats. So I bet you're going to see other add-on packages taking this idea, this innovation, this add-on, and they're going to copy them. But if you want it right now, the only place to get this is Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor. A content toggle. You see this all the time. I actually just showed you when I was on their pricing page. Here's a content toggle. They're actually using the content toggle right here where you've seen this. It's typically, you're going to see it on a pricing page. You can toggle it. And so this is showing one group of pricing tables. And then when you toggle it, the only thing that really changes is the price and some of the little bits of information underneath it and probably obviously where those buttons go. Isn't this cool? I mean, you could do this for lots of different things. As a matter of fact, let's go ahead and look on their website and see some of their examples of using the content toggle. So here's your most typical, or how we're used to seeing it, is for pricing like this to toggle between annual or monthly or annual and lifetime like you see here. But you can also toggle right here their existing and their upcoming features. You can toggle it right there and it just totally changes. There's so many different creative uses for this. We're really going to have to spend some time figuring it out, some of the creative uses for it. So let's go ahead and take a look at how the content toggle works. So here's how it works. When you add it, you have content one and content two. So each one will have a heading, and that's what you see right here where it says heading one and heading two. That's going to be the heading. And then your next option is the actual content that will show when someone is toggled on that particular choice. So you can choose content, and this would just be some text that you pop in there in this text box. But you also have those options of choosing a saved section or a saved page. And all you have to do is click on that, and then you'll get a drop down showing you a list of your saved sections and a list of your saved pages. That's all there is to it. Let me go back to content because I don't have any saved sections or saved pages. So you would do that for content one and content two. And then we go to style. And this is where you're going to get to control the style of the switcher itself. So first you would choose the default one to display, whether it be content one or content two. There's also switcher style. So this is round. Here's another variation of it like this. Wow, that's so cool. Here's a rectangle option. And then here's a label box where you could probably change the label. I think I like round one because that's what I'm most used to seeing. And then you get to choose your colors. So there's color one, color two, and then the controller color. So the controller color is that dark green, and color one is when it's toggled onto the first content option. Color two is when it's on the second one. Let me show you what that looks like in a preview. So here I am actually on it. So you can see on heading one, the background is that bluish When I click on it, it changes to that greenish color, and you can see it just perfectly toggles back and forth. So you have perfect design control over it. And then you have other controls that you're typically used to seeing here with Elementor. Let's go ahead and actually, let me go back. I forgot on their homepage, they have a list of things that are coming. Now I'm sure each week they'll add a new module or so. Over time, all these modules will be coming. Call to action, image gallery, which would be nice. A different take on pricing tables, price list, timeline, table. I'm looking forward to the table myself, an Instagram feed, and some WooCommerce add-ons, and there'll be more add-ons coming. I gotta say, I think that the Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor is a home run plugin, if you ask me. It's very affordable. Most of you that already have Astra Agency license, you're already getting it included, so it's there. It's ready for you to start using. I think when you go to my website, you're going to start seeing more and more of the modules that I'm using with Elementor and Elementor Pro. They're going to be these Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor add-ons that are available. I think they did a really good job here. I think some of the modules are similar to Elementor Pro stuff. I'd like to see that. Not actually Elementor Pro, just the normal Elementor, but they're going to be making them a little more useful. A perfect example of that is the info box. Now, part of the reason why they added this, there's something similar, but not the same, but it's a little on the similar side in the normal Elementor. So they have that here. Part of the reason they did that is for the designs that they're coming out with for their templates, the Astra starter sites. But all in all, I think it's a great bargain and value for what it will add to your Elementor website. And these are just things that you don't really have anywhere else. Obviously, you can tell I'm a little excited and enthusiastic about this product. Part of the reason is I know that it's going to be done and built the right way with performance in mind, just like they've done with all of their other add-on products. But that's what I think. I want to hear what you think about Ultimate Add-ons for Elementor in the comment section down below. Like I said, there's going to be a link in the video description. You can visit WPCrafter.com UAE/UAE. That will take you right on over to their website. You can check it out. There is that, just keep in mind, there is that discount. I don't know how long it's going to go for. My guess is maybe a week or two, but I could be wrong. It could be gone tomorrow. I don't know. I just actually noticed they were having the discount today. So anyways, thanks for watching this video. I'd love to hear from you in the comments. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video.